kickboxing over 3 2-minute rounds of full contact action. Would you welcome first into the blue corner, representing the Fighting Tigers, Jamie McGuigan. Welcome his opponent into the red corner, representing First Strike, Luke Diprose. McGuigan in the blue, Diprose in the red.
So will they have the same response for Luke Diprose? Big left roundhouse and Diprose slips from that, no harm done there. Diprose with the jab, just misses with the right hand, and both kick at the same time again. McGuigan gets through with the first meaningful roundhouse, then they tie up. And again, Diprose complains that that one was slightly low into the midsection, into the box. Foles talking to him, saying, I'll control this, don't worry about it. Just to keep them up. That roundhouse was definitely higher. And they both go at it once more. Diprose just misses with the roundhouse, and the right hook from McGuigan just misses as well. Short right from Diprose lands this time, and then McGuigan with two to the body. And now they both start to get through with their shots. And the helmet of McGuigan comes off. Again, neither man landing clean at the moment, but I feel they've planted their feet, so if everyone does land clean, it'll be full force. And to be honest, it was a difficult, scrappy opening round. So second of three, and they need to just settle down a bit, get behind some tidier work, and see who can land cleanly, because the power's there, the intent's there, it's just the accuracy at the moment. And the shot choice. Oh, and a good left from Diprose in that combination. And then heavy hands from McGuigan. And oh, good left hand again in that inside there from Diprose. And a good right roundhouse this time from McGuigan. And the right hand from McGuigan clips the jaw of Diprose, and he comes back now with his own shots. And as I said, it only needs for one of these cement to land solidly, cleanly, as McGuigan pushes forward now.
Jamie,
And again, both men not quite connecting cleanly. It's just out of range, or just defended. But there's a good right hand from Diprose there. And again, he is getting through just the cleaner of the two. You feel McGuigan has power, but he needs to land cleanly. And again, it's Diprose that gets through with the left hand. And good body shot for the first time from McGuigan, and Diprose felt that body shot. And McGuigan starts to blast to the body now. And it's actually the body shots of McGuigan that took their toll on Diprose. Now he storms forward. Oh, and that right hand, that's it. I thought he had power, but the right hand came in. It was a matter of time, and it is all over. I thought that if one of these men with the shots they were throwing landed clean, that would end it, and so it has for Jamie McGuigan against Luke Diprose. And our medic straight in. Safety first in this game.
But we do have a winner by way of KO in 1 minute 57 seconds of the second round. And he's from the blue corner, Jamie McGuigan. Ladies and gentlemen, we are ready to move on with 3 1.5 minute rounds of white collar boxing, as sponsored by Kickboxing. Would you welcome first into the blue corner, who are representing Combat Camp UK, Billy Lott.
Ain't nobody fucking with my click, 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 click. Ain't nobody fresh in my motherfucking click, 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 click.
Would you welcome his opponent into the red corner, representing the TKO gym, Michael Wagstaff.
So 3 1.5 minute rounds of white collar boxing. Billy Lott, Combat Camp UK. It's Michael Wagstaff from the local TKO gym. And Lott will have a height advantage. But Wagstaff looks to negate that by getting in close and working his man. Wagstaff trying to force the pace, but Lott is elusive. Moves nicely around the wing, away from trouble. And again, Wagstaff trying to close the gap and land the blows, but look, Billy Lott not letting him. Good right hand from Lott on the defense there. And big right hand from Lott misses the target. Would have been a different story if it landed. And again, Wagstaff trying to hunt his man down. But Lott proving ever elusive here in this first round. Wagstaff occasionally gets through. And the man forcing the pace. So if you're looking to give the round to someone, you really have got to go to the red corner, because although Blue was elusive, he wasn't throwing much back. second of three. Wagstaff doubles up the jab, and this time Lark comes back with his own lefts and rights. Looking to counter as he's backed up. And Wagstaff trying to stay on his man and keep the pace going and work. Lark pops out the double jab, misses with the right hand. Nice right hand to the body this time from Lark. Wagstaff looks to use his own right hand to push his man back. And again, it's Wagstaff trying to force the pace. Lark proving elusive once more. Oh, nice right hand from Wagstaff. Most meaningful shot of the fight so far. And again, it's a familiar pattern here in the second. Lark, edge of the apron. Wagstaff trying to wear his man down. Nothing meaningful except for that one right hand from Wagstaff. So third and final round, and it follows a familiar pattern after the first two. Good left hand counter this time though from Lart as Wagstaff came in. And again Wagstaff trying to force the pace, but Lart has proved elusive across this fight. And Wagstaff, although he's planted his feet, hasn't really managed to get the shots off like he would like to. And again, Wagstaff closes down nicely, but Lart throws out the jab, ducks and pushes away. And the clock's ticking now, and it's been a frustrating night for Wagstaff with the defensive skills of Billy Lart. I'd like to see Lart take more risks in this fight himself, offensively, but he's done a good job defensively. He's not been hurt. Whether he's won the fight or done enough for that is a different matter. I think maybe the judges will look favourably on the aggressive nature of Wagstaff's work. As the clock ticks down, and I think it will be a red win and a very hard worked one. Thank you.